Yeah, I think that listening prayer should be a huge part of leading worship in the sense that we're wanting to follow the Holy Spirit into the throne room of God. And so the better posture than, you know, us rushing ahead would obviously be to listen and then to sing from what we're hearing. Now, we can also be specific with that. So our worship leaders will often ask questions like, God, what's your heart for us? And so some of the worship will really be around God's heart for us, and also that idea of intimacy then creates the horizontal or the vertical worship, where I'm expressing my love and adoration for God's heart because He's first loved me. So if I really capture the idea of God's great love for me, then there'll be a natural response. I think that's super important so that we don't get in a habit of, well, if I can really impress God with my worship and sort of suck up to Him, then maybe He'll come down, and then it becomes about me leading the way to try to manipulate God to make Him do something. So if it starts with God's heart for us, then our worship becomes a response to the beautiful gospel and to the mercy of God and to His incredible kindness, and it'll gush that way. What we've also then experienced is, as we draw near to God in worship, some of our worship leaders then will begin feeling God's heart for the world, and will have a really almost a shift from then adoration into intercession for the world, and so that we're now singing over God's heart for the world in a way that's praying for that to go out and to bring peace and to bring comfort and to bring reconciliation to those on the outside. And then often they'll come and be drawn back into the focus on Jesus again. Now, I don't want that to sound like a formula, though, and yet it is a pattern that will happen. We hear God's heart for us. We begin to gush with love for Him. In doing so, we begin to remember others. And then we go from loving the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength to loving our neighbors as ourselves with the love of Jesus for them. So that's some of what we've experienced in being led by listening in our worship times. And I would say on those occasions when we really get it, it's very sweet and that then the presence of God isn't just this mist that comes in the room or an impersonal force, but it's really face-to-face communion with God in Christ through the Holy Spirit.